Live video starting. Live video starting. Live video starting. All right. We are here. Good morning, 9 a.m. You see, we have moved facilities. We are no longer in our nice facility at T3 Performance, but we are in a undisclosed location in Cleveland out here, making sure we get some work still. Coach CT, still Coach James here working with speed. We are going to need, moving forward, we have four towels. One, two, three, four. Again, like anything, you can get t-shirts, get hats, shoes, whatever you need. So we will need those later. All right, so we're gonna start, like always, through a warm-up. We're gonna do work in top speed today. So we'll go warm-up, and then we'll get into the speed. Then, as always, we'll do some pump stuff at the end. Also, I know what everybody's thinking. Why, CT, do you have sleeves on your t-shirt? Right, which I think is we might as well.
I was actually wondering, I didn't say anything.
Squash the elephant in the room. We welcomed, as a family, a new baby into our family last night. Colson Gregory is his name. He was born at 9/11 in the evening, so I'm wearing the blue to represent them. I think my sister and her husband and the new baby may be watching from the hospital, so this is their first workout. This is baby's first workout.
Yeah.
We can archive this, and he can watch it years now. Down the road. All right, so let's get going. We want to start moving, start getting the start rate up. Let's go jumping jacks. Let's go about 15 of them. Here we go, 3, 2, 1, go. Again, as we get moving in this, everybody will be with us for the warm up. If you have two athletes working at home, one go with me, one go with Coach James.
Just say something.
All right, from here, we're going to go knee tuck lunge. We're going to go knee tuck lunge. Here we go, and go. Knee tuck forward lunge. You can switch, knee tuck forward on.
Is it crooked?
Yeah, it's crooked.
Good morning, everybody out there tuning in.
Then you move over.
Workout number one, Quarantine Chronicles, where we are out at an undisclosed location, no longer at T3 Performance. We're still going to make sure we do everything to help you out at home. Make sure we're getting our speed work for the day. We'll go lateral lunges. Lateral lunges, we'll spread our feet just a little bit. I'll say right, we'll drop to the right. Hang out for a second, ready? And right, drop down. Shins nice and vertical, knees, ankle stacked. And switch, so sit back. Push yourself all the way out in that lateral lunge position.
It's Meredith, Eric.
And switch. Side to side, and switch.
Eric watching?
Yeah, he's watching.
What's up, Eric?
What's up, Eric?
We know Eric's doing the workout with us today.
Switch. Thanks for tuning in with us, brother. And switch. Last one. All right, we're going to go to a hand walk. We'll show you from the side. Hand walk, and then we'll come up into a single leg RDL. Right? So we usually walk out all the way here. Plank position, throw that push-up in. Now we'll walk ourselves back up into that single leg RDL. Walk yourself down. Push-up. Switch leg. Get a couple of these, 5 or 6 on each side. Go ahead and get moving there.
Meredith's trying to tell me something. I don't know.
I'm just going to do it out in the hallway.
Oh.
Come on each leg, don't go to the ground. It's a little tough coming up on one leg, but you always go for two. Let's go one more each leg. And take it down to the ground. One leg up, supine leg kicks, hamstring kicks. Ankles flexed, toes up towards the ceiling, kick it up into that hammy, try to keep the lower back attached, shoulders attached, and switch legs. All right, we'll keep this leg up here in about 5 reps. 2, 1, arms up to the side, single leg overs. Take a leg all the way to the side. Touch the ground. All the way back. Try not to kick your partner next to you. Unless you don't like that partner, go ahead and kick him. Don't tell him I told you to.
Little roundhouse to the face.
Switch legs. Side to side. Keep going. All right, I want to fire up the core a little bit while we're down here too. Alternating V-ups, we'll go 10 each side. Opposite hand to the opposite toe. Let's go 10 each and we'll flip over.
Belle is actually up in her room eating her peanut butter right now.
Just ask about the pups.
Yeah, Eric is.
We gave her a tranquilizer. She's gonna be out.
All right, roll on over. All fours, quadruped position. 4-point position, we're gonna hit circles. Hip circles, we'll start on the left. Keep the leg back, out to the side and front. We'll go 5 forward, 5 backwards. A couple more down here and we'll be up. Switch sides. Good morning, everybody who's joining us. Thank God for being with us. And backwards. We appreciate y'all. We'll go push-up position. Groiners, one of our favorite here, a couple of these. And then we'll be up, push up position, right foot up and outside the right hand. Back leg will be off the ground when I say switch. We'll jump the left leg up and outside the left hand. If you want to step back, we can do that as well. Maybe a little easier. Step back and jump up, here we go. Ready and switch. This one sits down a little bit, switch. Switch, 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 switch. A couple more, switch, switch, switch. And relax. Go ahead and be up on our feet, all right? Gonna start a little plyometric work. Make sure our ankles, our feet, our knees are all ready to go before we get into the top speed. So everything we're gonna be doing is in place here. We're gonna start with just pogo jumps, some of my favorite. Again, everybody's gotta get those ankles, feet ready to go. All right, you see, we don't have our shoes on, not only because we wanna be able to feel the ground, but also because we were raised well by our parents and take our shoes off inside. Alright, so we're gonna start with pogos. I'm gonna go 5 pogos, arms are gonna be down. Jump up as high as I can, almost as high as I can, just so I don't hit my head up here. I'm gonna go 5, try to be explosive as I can, and spend as little time on the ground as possible. James, you wanna start?
Yeah.
Here we go, we'll go 5. If you're working with James, keep working with James. Here we go, ready, and go. Hands are down, slight knee bend, trying to get bouncy, trying to rebound off the ground. Next out the up, we'll go 5. But you'll see from the side, we're not dropping down to a squat and jumping up. Again, trying to get bouncy and quick, spend as little time on the ground as possible. Let's go again. Go 3 rounds here, 5. One more time. Priming our body here, priming our body to be able to move as quick as possible, as efficiently as possible. Last time here. All right, we're gonna switch to single leg. We're switch to single leg pogos. And if you're Coach James, go ahead and hit it. We're gonna go 5 on the right. Go ahead. This is gonna be almost the foundation for the positions we're gonna be in here. 5 and 5. Again, feel the ground with your foot. Not going down to a big squat. And if you want to make this a little easier, just don't jump as high up off the ground. Right? We'll go one more time each leg. There we go. Last time. Last time. Again, this will be a foundational movement for everything we're doing moving forward. All right. Here we go. Now we're going to do a little ankling in place. Little ankling to play. So everything we do when we get moving, we will start here just so we have a good rhythm. All right, like James talked about last week, imagine step over, you know, something that's 3 inches tall. Toes have to be up. We're thinking about striking on our toe pad here, right? Not towards the middle of our foot, but more towards the front, right there on the toe pad. Ankles are going to come up every time we strike the ground. All right, so we're going to go in place. We'll go for about 10 seconds. Talk through it again. We'll have a nice little rhythm. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. See, knees are coming up and quick, driving down and back into the ground. Toes are always up off the ground. Not getting down into the heels, staying athletic. 3, 2, 1, and relax. Ready, next athlete, and go. Like we're riding a mini unicycle. Keep those arms involved.
3.
I learned that from this guy
1 and
years
2.
Ago. That helps connect it all. One more time like that, ready, go. Good, 8 seconds. 3, two, one, relax. Remember, this is how we're going to start every movement when we get into the drills. Here we go. Next athlete. Try to spend as little time as possible on the ground. Still good position here with our core and upper body.
Three, two, one, and go.
All right, now, we're going to put a single leg butt kicker in, right? This will look like single leg A-skip, all right? But the focus is on heel coming up to the butt, okay? First position here when we're getting into top speed. Heel up to the butt, right? Then we'll extend and pull down and come through. Here, just focusing on starting with that ankling in place. Every time we say hit, left leg comes up to the butt, and then continue that cycling going down low there. Here we go. Go about five and we'll switch. Ready, and go. We're moving. Hit, one step. Hit, 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 hit. One more. Hit. Good. Relax. See how that's done. Go ahead and switch partners.
Yep. And hit.
And we'll switch legs. Go on the right leg. Ready? Go. Hit. 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 Good. Two more. Hit. Hit. And relax. Good. You'll also notice, again, we talk about position. You won't see James get out of position, right? We're not hitting here. Okay, stay in that good brace position. Heel up to the butt every time. We'll go five more.
Hit. Think about this drill. It's so much about body position, body awareness, without like being able to see where we're at in space. You don't watch yourself play sports, you play sports. So you should know where your body's at without having to see it in a mirror, seeing it in a video screen. You should automatically know. So if this technique is something you need to work on, spend some extra time on it, getting that knee drive up outside of the workout.
Awesome. Awesome. Let's take it to the next step. Next step with this. All right, heel up to the butt. Now we're going to cycle through a little bit. Heel, come up. Knee shoots out in front, toes always dorsiflexed, and we claw right back underneath us, right? So we're here, every hit, we're up and through, up and through, up and through, and then getting right back to the same position. Remember, we want to strike underneath. If we strike in front of us with our toe down, it sends us back, right? When we're accelerating, we're driving back behind us, it sends us forward. Now we want to strike right underneath our foot to maintain those good positions. Here we go, it'll be ankling again in place, and then step over, excuse me. And we're moving, and hit. Heel up and through, strike down below him. Hit. Nice. Hit. 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 One more. Hit. Nice. Next side, get up.
Hit. Hit.
Switch it up, switch it up. Thanks everybody for tuning in. If you're joining us now, see we're doing ankling in place. We're throwing in a B skip or a step over run here. Ready? Hit. Heel up and through. Hit. Knee up, toe up. Hit. 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 Got two more. Hit. Hit. And relax. Left leg, we'll go right this time. Take those same positions. We're gonna move with it a little bit, all right? So, now is where you wanna get out your towels, get out your t-shirts, grab a drink, relax for just a second. We'll set these up. We'll do them, I think, where we're coming towards you. Maybe the first couple. Get those in.
Good morning, Josh.
Coach Josh, what's going on? Thanks for watching.
Signing in, logging in, vlogging in, checking in. Pre-registered.
Speak it up, who's a 10?
Who's a 10?
Is it Josh?
I think Josh, you're a 10, right?
Remember, 8 a.m. 8 a.m., Ryan was at home. doing an adult fit workout. Awesome workout. We followed along with that. 9 a.m. is going to be Coach James and I. As you see here, 10 a.m. is going to be Coach Josh from home. All right. Now, we have our towels, your t-shirts, your brothers and sisters, whatever, laid out here on the ground. All right. Now, in between each towel, we're going to do that ankling. We're just going to be moving with it a little bit. Now, every time you hit a towel, we're going to start with that butt kicker that we have here. And then we'll move forward. Every time you get to the towel, you'll go throw that knee drive in there. So, four on the right side, we'll go through twice and we'll switch. All right, so you'll see here ankling in place. Then we'll get up to the towel, hit a butt, move forward, hit a butt, move forward. There we go. Next athlete up, and go ahead, get moving. Make sure you got a good little rhythm going. It's real quick. Heel comes up. Foot drives back down to the ground. We'll go another time here. Shuffling, let everybody catch up at home. Changes so fast, sometimes it's hard to keep up with them. Heel up. Good, one. One rep every time we hit a towel. Nice, nice, nice. We'll switch sides, we'll switch sides. We want left leg, left leg. Like you talked about the other day, right? We might have one side that's a little easier, one side that's a little tougher. All right, if you feel good on one side, comfortable on one side, the other one's harder, make sure you get some more reps in. Again, this is a great time to do it, right? Many reps as we can get in. Let's steal them while we can. We know we're doing them. Not everybody's out there doing them. All right, ankling in place. Now we're moving. Other leg comes up to the heel. Be as quick as you can. Maintain those good positions. Left leg now. Shouldn't really feel those toes be in contact with the ground. Again, that heel pad is what we're looking at. Heel pad, toe pad, excuse me, what we're looking at. All right, right underneath your toe. Toe will be up. Ankle should be nice and loose by now. As you get comfortable, speed those up. Good reps in between. And we're going again.
We got confirmation Josh is the 10th.
Excellent, excellent. Signing and logging and vlogging in. Nice, all right. Now take it to the next step. We go with that step over run. Grab whatever you need.
So what's the difference between a step over run and a butt kick?
I think
some people out there are wondering.
Starting to gain some ground here. All right. Butt kicker is just going to take our heel up into the butt. All right. But if we stay here, we wouldn't get too far. Right? Because we're going straight up and down. Step over now. Heel comes up. Knee comes out in front. We've got to get through hip extension, knee extension, then to pull us moving forward. Right? Again, we talk about dorsiflexion here to make sure we strike underneath our hip to pull us forward. If our toe's down, when we go through and touch, it'll send us back. All right? So this is where we start moving a little bit and gaining some ground. Is there anything you want to add to that?
Perfect.
All right? Okay. So, again, same thing. We'll be in place. We'll get moving a little bit and then throw that step over run in there and keep going forward. Nice little rhythm. All right, every time we get to a towel, here we go first athlete up and go. We're in place. Now we're moving. Step over. Step over. And switch it up. Strike right underneath your hip. Great reps there. We'll go again for a second time. I like to start in place until I feel that rhythm, until I got it figured out. Then I'll get moving. Love it. Love it. Let's go the other. Let's go the other side. Another side. Get up your home following along with us. Make sure you get it recorded. Get a part of your workout recorded. Send it to us, T3 Performance. Send it to me. Send it to James. We'll get you out on our feeds. Try to inspire some people around us here. And let's go. Other leg. Up through. Getting a lot of work in a small space. Showing everybody that it is possible to get faster, to get better, in a condensed amount of space here. Let's go. Other leg.
Use your coupon to take 15% off
right,
your
too.
Or check out great spring specials for you, your family, and your home.
Good rhythm.
Everyone gets free shipping.
Again, like you say, if it doesn't feel athletic, it's probably not athletic. Check your positions. If you need to slow it down and break it down, if you need to record it, watch the video. You can do that right? That helps us get through a lot of those tough positions that we can't feel. Well, we can feel, but we can't see. Alright? So, take two out in the middle. Now, just like the other day, we're going to get as many reps as we can get in. And we've got about 4 feet. We've got about 4 feet here. Should we turn this one to the side? You can do that, give him a little different out.
5'8". We got 5 feet and 8 inches, exactly. We got about 5 feet and 8 inches.
Exactly.
So that's all you need.
All right, so same thing. We're going to start in place. Going to start in place. Once you're comfortable, we're going to start moving. Then we're going to do as many butt kickers as possible. Remember, we're not going here with the butt kicker where we're falling forward. We're going here, straight up, toes up, heels up here to the bottom. All right, take a couple reps again. We should be bracing hard enough through our core that this wears us out a little bit, right? As we go through this, as Coach James figured out this 5'8" area. All right, so step over, run in place, and butt kicker when we get to the first down. Here we go, and go, start in place. Speed that up and go.
There we go. Yeah. 32 reps.
All right, 32. Trying to count. I'm trying to get a lot of work done. Nice, 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 nice. Toes up, knees up, heels to the butt. We'll go again. Go again. If you catch up at home, if we're all good, here we go. Ready and ankle. Start moving.
There we go. Good.
Getting up in the 40s and 50s of reps. Nice. Woo. Nice. We'll go one more. One more round that way. Try to get in as many reps as we can.
You know, one thing CT said about knee extension. Before hip extension earlier, or hip extension before knee extension. This is gonna drive down before that straightens out. So even here, I'm driving down and then getting straight. We see a lot of people, like CT was saying, reaching out to pull forward. This is a great drill for someone who maybe has had some hamstring issues in the past. These tight cycles can help you fix getting out here, all right, as opposed to driving down. All right, and being able to get forward with your running.
If you didn't hear that, make sure when you watch it on replay, you check that out again and again. That's some really important stuff. Knowledge bombs he's dropping here, just for free on a Tuesday morning. Whew. Here we go, one more time with the butt kicker. And we're in place. And go.
There we go, quick. Yeah.
Hey, nice. Next athlete up. Reps. Perfect position. Arms look great. Lower body looks great. We'll add that step over to it now. So from here, a couple more of these from here, we're going step over on, right? Like we're talking about knee up in front. Toe up. Here we go. A lot of reps. We go in here once we're comfortable. Woo!
A little softer than that carpet we were used to.
Right. Got this nice new carpet down here inside this closed location. The bunker. Yeah. A lot of reps. Going two more times there. Two more times again because we're trying to be explosive and powerful. He should wear you out pretty good. After a couple sets here, we're going to go through one strength circuit to get ourselves a pump. Then we'll get y'all out of here. Here we go. We're in place and we're moving. Nice, here we go, coaches up. Reps, nice. One more time. Deep breath here. Make this set the best set here. It's gonna be the last one. Make this one the best one. Here we go, ready? In place, nice and bouncy. Toes out in front, start to tighten that up. And you go.
There we go.
Woo! A lot of reps, means we can get in. Nice. Nice. Go ahead and grab those towels. Pick them up. Good work. We'll grab a drink.
What do we need for the strength circuit?
We're just going to need... What's up, everybody? Trying to see if we got any questions. Moving forward.
How important is arm action for speed? I think there's a lot of things in the cycle that need to happen first. But from an athletic perspective, you know, arm action can hurt us more than it can help us. So if we have bad arm action, it's going to kind of mitigate a lot of the leg drive that we're creating. And it's going to get that out of... This shouldn't be rotating. There's going to be some small rotations in our hips. So if we have those two forces opposing each other, it's going to hurt us. So the simpler the better. And I like open hands. I don't know.
That's it, yeah. That's a great question. Great answer. The only other thing I'll add to that is remember to go as fast as we can forward. We want everything to be moving forward, right? So we talk about arm action. If we can get everything straight, help our force going forward, move it efficiently, then we're good. If we get any type of side to side, that sends us these ways around instead of forward, and it'll slow us down that way. All right, so there's a lot of things we can fix from the waist down that can help us there. And then that arm action is just added in to help move us quick. Great question. All right, so here's what we're gonna do. Five exercises, push up, split stance lunge. You knew we'd do that. Split stance lunge, bodyweight squats, straight leg sit-ups, all right? We're gonna go for as many reps as we can in 30 seconds, then we'll get 30 seconds to break and transition to the next one, all right? Follow along with us. If you need to break at all, go ahead and break, but try to work straight through for 20 seconds. Also, if we're resting on push-ups, try to rest at the top instead of resting with your legs down. All right, remember, it's only 30 seconds of work. Only 30 seconds of work.
Oh, no.
Get the mascot involved here.
Oh, no.
All right. House mascot. So we're going to start.
What did
you
do?
She's
going
to do this with us.
Let's start with a 30-second in rep.
Out there.
Get the timer going.
Good.
Let's go. Bodyweight squats first.
Oh, yeah.
All right, we're going 10 seconds. Bodyweight squats in 10 seconds. Get it, remember, many as we can do in five.
You can stay with us.
Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go.
Hi.
Yeah. 15 seconds now. Goal is 1 second if we can get there. 5 seconds, keep going, many as we got. You can add some weight. 2, 1, relax. All right, you'll get 30 seconds.
You didn't see that coming, did you? You didn't see that
Shake
coming.
Shake those legs out, grab a drink, we'll go. 10 seconds, we'll go split stance lunges. Whew. All right. 15 seconds. Thanks for tuning in, you're with us at home. 5 seconds, whatever leg you want in front. Here we go, 3, 2, 1, and go. As many reps as we can get.
Hey, she's afraid now.
Nice. Only 10 seconds in.
Ooh. Yeah, too many.
Slider reps. 10 seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1, time. All right. 30 seconds to go to the other leg, then we'll be on the ground.
There she is. Eric says hi.
Here we go, going to 10. All right, here we go. And 3, 2, 1, go. Many reps as we got. If you're just tuning in with us, we went over top speed at about 20 minutes of top speed.
And I started here.
Again, we're trying to tell you that you can get better, you can get faster in a small area. Not saying this is a small area by any means. I mean, no disrespect by that. Just smaller than being out at a facility, being out at a gym. Get a Harry starter set with a and we can do a ton of strength stuff to keep our gains. 3, 2, 1. $3 plus free shipping. Just go to Harry's.com and enter Pandora. I saw one of my buddies, one of my coaches, who's in Indianapolis, is calling this maintains season instead of gains season, right? What can you do to maintain the gains that you've made over the last amount, however long you've been training? 10 seconds, we'll go to push-ups. This will be the second to last one. As many push-ups as we can do in 5 seconds. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Many as we can do, many as we can do. A lot of people doing those push-up challenges. You can go ahead and tag people on this.
I don't know why it takes a pandemic for people to start doing push-ups all of a sudden.
2, 1, relax. All right, last one's gonna be straight leg sit-ups. And isn't that the truth? Yeah. Takes everybody to be cooped up at home to start doing push-ups. And ain't right, something to think about. Straight leg sit-ups. Legs are gonna be out in front of us. 15 seconds we'll go, hands are gonna go from behind us to all the way out front, try to touch our toes. Here we go, 5 seconds. A lot of reps. Here we go, 3, 2, 1, go. Some momentum. I'm too fast. Not a chance. Keep going, as we can do. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and relax. That is our time. Here, you want to go back through, watch it again, take some more reps, go through this a couple more times, be excellent again. The goal is to go for as many as we can without stopping. Once we have to stop, we're thinking as many reps as possible in that amount of time. So you're pretty well fatigued during it. Anything else you want to say? We're back again tomorrow.
Yeah, back tomorrow.
9 a.m. Remember, you can hang out 10 a.m. on T3 Performance's Instagram page. We'll be back at 9 a.m. Again, welcome to the world. My new nephew. So I'm wearing the blue. Colston Gregory. Happy birthday to my mom who's watching back at home. Everybody have a wonderful day. Stay positive. Practice some gratitude. Tell the people that you love them. We'll see y'all tomorrow, same time.
Slow feet don't eat.